Welcome to Ask Us Whatever. I'm Joe Sorge. In episode 9.1, we learned about relativistic velocity addition according to the special theory of relativity. And although the textbook formula is simple, the details behind the formula reveal its dependence on length contraction and Einstein's synchronized clocks. And since these lengths and clocks must be adjusted for each observer, the conflicting constraints that would be imposed by multiple observers in multiple reference frames makes the velocity addition formula and the underlying special theory of relativity unworkable. To bring some reality to velocity addition, we're going to derive the alternative model velocity addition formula and base it on velocities with respect to a preferred reference frame. We'll first start with two reference frames using the alternative dx and dt transformations that you've seen in earlier episodes, and then we'll expand the analysis to multiple reference frames. Gamma s is computed using the speed v of a given moving frame relative to our preferred reference frame s, as measured in frame s meters per second. The distance dx prime is how far an object or observer in frame s prime moves between events within frame s prime. Recall that meter sticks in the alternative model do not contract, so a meter prime is a meter, and a meter is a meter. dt prime is the time that elapses while the object or observer moves distance dx prime within frame s prime, as measured with two frame s prime clocks separated by that distance dx prime. Note that the two clocks in frame s prime are Einstein synchronized, which means that clock b prime will report an earlier time of day than clock a prime. Therefore, the computation of elapsed time dt prime will be affected not only by the time dilated tempo of clocks a prime and b prime, but also by the difference between the readings being displayed by clocks A prime and B prime. Since clock offset amounts are computed using reference frame speed relative to a universal preferred reference frame, clocks will not need to be readjusted for different observers, as must be done for special relativity. If this does not make sense, please watch episode 7.2 for an explanation. The speed of an observer who is moving within frame S prime, as observed and measured from frame S, is then computed by dividing the alternative dx transformation by the alternative dt transformation. For simplicity, we will call speed dx dt u. If we divide numerator and denominator by gamma S times dt prime, we get the following. The speed, dx prime dt prime, is the speed of the object or observer relative to frame s prime as measured in meters per second prime. Let's call that speed u prime. We then have speed u being equal to gamma s times u prime plus v, all divided by 1 plus v times u prime over gamma s times c squared. This formula resembles the relativistic velocity addition formula from special relativity, except for the gamma s factors. It allows us to compute the speed u of a frame s prime object or observer relative to frame s. We can rearrange the formula to find the speed of the frame s prime object or observer u prime as observed from within frame s prime, provided that we know the speed v of frame s prime and the speed of the object or observer u with respect to frame s. U prime is equal to u minus v all divided by gamma s minus u times v over gamma s times c squared. Note that both u and v are measured using a single clock in frame S, and so this formula does not require the synchronization of clocks in frame S. However, the output of this formula, u prime, if actually measured in frame S prime, would involve two Einstein synchronized clocks in frame S prime. This is because the alternative dt and dt prime transformations assume synchronized clocks in frame s prime, as do the dt and dt prime transformations in special relativity. We could write the dt and dt prime transformations assuming absolutely synchronized clocks in frame s prime, but that's for a future episode. There's another formula that will become handy when we begin to look at symmetries between multiple frames. Let's assume that a frame that we call frame s double prime, or some object within frame s prime, moves at speed u with respect to frame s. Then its speed relative to frame S prime, denominated in frame S meters per second, can be computed by simply subtracting V from U. This speed is the distance that S double prime, or an object moving within frame S prime, moves with respect to frame S prime divided by elapsed time measured with clocks in frame S. If we are interested in the speed at which observers in frame S double prime observe frame S prime to be moving, we need to convert dt to dt double prime. If we use only one clock in frame S and one clock in frame S double prime, the time dilation factor between frames S and S double prime will be equal to gamma S computed using their relative speeds U. And so the speed difference between frames S double prime and S prime, as measured by observers who are stationary within frame S double prime, is gamma S comma U times U minus V meters per second double prime. Okay, that lays the groundwork for velocity addition in the alternative model. In the next episode, we will generalize the concept so that we can compute relative velocities between multiple objects and multiple reference frames. So if you have any questions, please write them in the comment section. I'm Joe Sorge, and thanks for watching.